Greetings. I watched a story on NBC News last night. The title of the segment was Honor Killings. That's when a Mohammedan murders females in his family who will not submit. Now, as you watch this story, pay attention. NBC is afraid to use the words Muslim or Islam. As you watch the story, listen to how the talking heads avoid using Muslim and Islam.
Thanks. A verdict has been reached in a murder case that's gotten a lot of attention because it involves so-called honor killings of family members by family members.
Family members by family members. That makes it sound so chaotic, so random, so hard to predict. But what this news hack is not telling you is that it is always men doing the killing, and largely by Mohammedan men. Although, to be fair, such misogyny does occur in almost all pagan cults. But in this case, it is a Mohammedan, a Muslim, who murdered his wife and three daughters.
In this case, by an Afghan family living in Canada. It is a culture clash that is getting a lot of attention to our north.
A culture clash? Evidently, news pukes don't know Islam is more than just a religion. Islam is a political and cultural system of totalitarian control.
NBC's Kevin Tibbles has the story.
Three teenage sisters all murdered because of how they wanted to live their lives. Dressed like Westerners, use the internet, meet boys. Also killed their father's first wife. By a strict religious family.
Let's paint all religion with this brush of intolerance. Let's not say Muslim or Islam because that would paint all Muslims. But in liberal minds, all religions are evil.
They felt it had been disgraced.
Why did he do it? In their father's words, dishonored and betrayed both their family and Islam.
For strong, vivacious, and freedom-loving women were murdered by their own family.
Convicted of the crime, the girl's father, mother, and brother, immigrants from Afghanistan.
Immigrants from Afghanistan. Taliban Central. The Islamic hellhole where the whole 9/11 adventure began.
In 2009, the women were drowned and their bodies placed in a car that was then pushed into a canal to look like an accident. They may call it honor killing, but in delivering the guilty verdict, the Canadian judge called it a sick notion of honor that has absolutely no place in any civilized society.
Where the judge showed he too has no balls is he did not dare call out Islam. But until the West and specifically civilized countries address Islam head-on, the cancer of Islam will grow.
59-year-old Mohammed Shafia, a wealthy Afghan businessman, came to Canada in 2007. The court was told how Shafia ruled his home with a rod of iron, and that eldest daughter Zainab was even forbidden to attend school because she had a boyfriend. The young woman had texted the boy saying, "Be aware of my bro."
It is impossible to know how many honor killings take place in North America, experts say, because they're often mistaken for domestic violence or disguised as accidents.
They are associated with patriarchal cultures.
Now this gal is a hoot. She wants to paint patriarchal cultures as all the same. But I want to point something out to you. Judaism is the oldest surviving patriarchal society I can imagine. And for the life of me, I cannot recall ever hearing about a Jewish man killing his wife or his daughter in a so-called honor killing. So let's not curse all patriarchy just to avoid saying Muslim and Islam.
Where men see themselves as the owners of women.
It took a jury 15 hours to convict all three of first-degree murder, which in Canada carries an automatic sentence of life in prison. Kevin Tibbles, NBC News, Chicago.
I'm not shocked by the murder. Islam is a religion of murder for infidels. I'm shocked that liberal journalists are such pussies and so afraid of Islam. After all, they are so brave when it comes to stalking Sarah Palin. So brave taunting Republican debaters. But so scared they pee themselves rather than say Muslims commit honor killings. As you watch the liberal media, keep your eyes open. Watch how they shirk their duties. Their bias and agenda is as obvious in the facts they omit and soft-pedal as the pejoratives they hurl. In these last days, the media will be as big a part of selling Islam to the West as the lies of people like Naik and Didat. They will raise hell over one church burning Korans and ignore that the U.S. military burned hundreds, if not thousands, of Bibles. Oh, that was to not upset the Mohammedans we were liberating in Afghanistan. Afghanis like these murderers who read the Quran and think killing women is okay. We don't want killers like that accidentally reading a Bible and getting saved. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.